and she's prepared to wait forever and a day. She's dreaming her life away.
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 When the world stops turning, she'll still be waiting for love. Na 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 na. When the sun stops burning, she'll still be waiting for love. Na 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 na. When the world stops turning, she'll still be waiting for love. Na 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 na.
If she don't shake the tree, the peaches won't fall down.
Hang on, I'll be right down. Hey, honey, what's up?
Nothing really. Finally. End of school. Anyway, not much to do but chill out, veg out, and catch up on some movies.
Yeah, Lindsay, about that. Never guess who I just got off the phone with. It was your Uncle Jack.
Uncle who?
Uncle Jack, and you know exactly who I'm talking about.
Oh yeah, that hermit that's supposed to be part of our family.
Hey, watch the attitude. He is family. And I think it's time we start pulling this family together from all sides.
That's because for the past 10 years, ever since you started inviting him down here, he always goes, someday.
Well, that someday is today. Lindsay, I just volunteered you to spend some time with him while he's recovering from his surgery. He needs his family right now.
What? But Mom, that's between you and your brother. It's my vacation, how could you do this?
Look, it has been a long road for all of us these past 10 years. I'm not asking for a lot. I just want you to spend a little time with him, and then your brothers and I will go to Minnesota, and we can all be together as a family.
Well, I'm not saying yes, but if I did go, when would I have to leave for Hicksville?
I thought maybe you could go on Wednesday and we could book a flight tonight.
Could I bring Izzy and Madison with me?
Don't tell me you want to bring those two.
Yes, those two.
Hey. Oh.
Besides, I know you wouldn't want me riding alone.
No, I wouldn't want you to ride alone. How about if we talk about it tonight and still do the pizza night?
All right, 8 o'clock.
Sounds good. You pick the movie.
Got it.
Don't leave me like this. Don't leave me stranded.
No, it won't. We're going west. All right, Mom. We're packed and ready to go.
Okay, I want you to be safe. I want you to stick together. I don't want you to take any unnecessary risks. And I want to make sure that you call me every single time you're at a gas station.
Don't worry, Mom. We'll take care and we will call you.
Okay, so you've got your stuff, you've got your cash, emergency credit card, everything's good to go?
Yep. I'm more worried about you with my two brothers. Yikes.
Your brothers will be just fine unless you want them to go along.
We'll pass on that.
That's your other brother.
I call shotgun.
All right, hon.
Why did Madison have fun out there?
Be careful.
You said that you'd always
be good. Say hi to your Uncle Jack for me.
Got it.
All All right, I'll see you in a little while. Be careful, girls. No strangers. No speeding. Promise?
Promise.
Okay.
That? There's a noise coming from your trunk. How much did you pack, Linz?
Maybe it's the motor in the back.
No, Izzy, the motor isn't in the back of the car.
Besides, no matter how much I packed, it wouldn't be making a noise like that.
Well, either way, you should probably pull over so we can figure out what it is. Don't leave me like this. Don't leave me stranded.
Did you hear that? There it is again, and the motor's off. That's strange.
What's strange is that Izzy thinks it's strange. But here, I'll go get a rock, then you open the trunk and I'll stun it. Then we just leave it here like it's roadkill.
Oh. It's Nick? What the heck are you doing in there?
This should be interesting.
I was looking for my video game and I fell asleep, and so now I'm starving, so let's get something to eat.
Are you crazy? We're halfway from home to Uncle Jack's now. Oh, Mom must be freaking out. I can't be seen traveling with some 12-year-old boy. He's probably gonna start stinking any second.
Hey, I don't stink.
What?
Do I?
I'll let Mom decide.
No, don't call Mom, please. You know, it's common fact that girls are much safer traveling with a male companion.
Yeah, the operative word there is male. Hey, Mom, it's Lindsay. You're not gonna believe what I just found. Yeah, it's Nick. He's stowed away in the trunk. It's a long story, but everything's fine now. Fine. I guess we'll just have to take him with us. Yeah. I love you too. Call you at the next stop. Bye.
You so owe me.
She'll be so sweet. Where do I get a sit?
You're back in the trunk.
You seem to like it so far.
Now she won't look back no more. Now she won't look back.
Too late to turn around, you know. How about a vote?
Lindsay, his house is right there. Why would we turn around now? Besides, Mom would be really mad.
Lindsay, let's just do this. I have a feeling we're never going to be the same after this.
Izzy, are you on any medications that we should be aware of?
Nope.
Okay.
So it's settled. Let's just go.
No one's here. And if you keep knocking, some lead's gonna come flying your way.
Uncle Jack, Uncle Jack! It's Lindsay! There's some pretty big bugs out here. Can you please let us in? I think one's taking off with Nick.
Come on in. Sorry, I thought it was one of those solicitor folks. Come on now, all the bugs are coming in.
Uncle Jack? It's Lindsay. And Nick, remember?
It's been a long time.
Well, Mom was really worried about you. She sent us down here all the way from Massachusetts.
She did, huh?
Because of your surgery.
Look, honey, I know I told your mom that you didn't need to come down here because, well, I'm fine just by myself. But since you came all this way and you brought your friends, and well, Nicholas too, might as well bunk down for the night. Guess it'll be good to have some company. The room's right down the hall there. If you want to just go down, I'll stop down later and make sure you're okay.
Nick, you can take my luggage.
You can handle two. And you can take my... Gotta build those muscles eventually. Girls these days.
Yeah. Tell me about it.
Where did you find that old fossil anyway?
I call this chair.
What's wrong, Lindsay?
I don't know, I kind of feel like this whole trip is turning into...
Lindsay, it's not all about you and your precious vacation. Uncle Jack's a great man because he saved a bunch of people from getting killed at that bank robbery. For some unknown reason, he needs us. At least that's what Mom says. Hey, where did everyone go?
Nothing really. Just checking out the scenery.
Hey, what kind of horse is that right there?
I think it's a quarter horse.
Actually, it's an Arabian, and his name is Wildfire. He's an old show horse. I bet you didn't know that all horses are part Arabian.
Well, he sure is a pretty horse. That is if he's a he.
Yeah, he is definitely a he.
I like his coat. It's not like all the other horses.
Well, when Wildfire was younger, he won a lot of trophies and ribbons. But then one day, Jack just stopped showing him, just gave it all up. Well, that's what I hear anyways. It was years ago.
Well, there's definitely a lot more to Uncle Jack than meets the eye.
Oh, so Jack's your uncle. You know, he told me some city slickers might be coming into town, but I didn't know if he was telling the truth. I'm sorry if I offended you by talking about your uncle like that.
Oh, no. It's okay. I'm Lindsay, and this is Nick.
Well, Lindsay and Nick, it's nice to meet you. Logan Smith, at your service.
Yeah. I think I'm out of here. Wow. Everything seems brighter all of a sudden.
Come on, Nick. Get up.
Don't worry, he'll be fine. It barely got him, I hope. I've seen worse. Last winter, this kid stuck his tongue to a pole. Ouch, man, I'm sorry. I thought everybody knew not to grab an electric fence. I'm sorry I didn't warn you, little man.
Who you calling little? Hey, what's that smell? I think I'm gonna go back to the house and lay down for a while.
Okay, so we're clearly not from around here.
You think?
What's that supposed to mean? Oh, that's right. I'm supposed to be out milking cows or something, right?
Well, first off, this is a horse ranch, so we don't have cows. And in case you missed it, you're stepping in horse poop.
Oh, thanks a lot. You could have told me sooner. A whole lot of help you're turning out to be. I've known you for 10 minutes, and my feet are covered in horse waste, and my brother is human toast.
Hang on. I'll help you clean it off.
Never mind. Hey, Nick. Nick, over that way.
With his lying eyes, he tells her, say, 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 it isn't so. That's all I need to know.
Did you see those new bales of straw we got to put in the stalls?
Yeah, yeah. Do you want me to give them to all the horses?
Yeah, if you don't mind.
Okay.
A little cleaning up in there.
Do you want me to bring them back there too?
Yeah, if you could, yeah.
Okay. So I hear prices at Obi-Tone are going up. Do you think it'll be smart to stock up for the weekend? Oh, and do you still want me to fix that fence in the southwest corner over there?
Yeah, yeah, that'd be good.
Okay.
Logan, I really appreciate your help here. Are you sure it's okay for you to be working down here?
Yeah, yeah, it's fine.
All right, let me know if it's a problem, okay?
I will.
Hey, Uncle Jack.
Hey,
hey Logan.
Lizzie.
Well, Uncle Jack, you've met Izzy and Madison, but Logan, you haven't. So, Logan? Madison and Izzy.
Hi.
Izzy, Madison, and Logan.
What's up, girls? Hey, so, Lindsay, you found any more poop to step into today?
So, Uncle Jack, is there anything us girls can do on the ranch?
Oh, yeah, is there anything fun to do? Hey, maybe we could learn how to shoot like Annie Oakley.
Logan, maybe you can find some things for the girls to do, all right?
Yeah.
Uncle Jack, I'm really good with numbers, and I learned this awesome new spreadsheet last semester.
Well, I don't know if I want you to get involved in all that yet. Why don't we just start with some simple chores, all right?
Well, I'm sure Logan would agree with me when I say that when it comes to physically helping on the ranch, I'm not all that great.
Well, we do know she's good at cleaning up after the horses.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'm not real happy about you getting involved in the book work, but I'm not gonna say no. Just stay out of trouble, promise?
Promise.
All right. Hey, Jack. Hey, how's it going?
How you doing?
So good, how are you?
Doing good.
Hey, Logan, what's up, dude?
Hey, not much. So, word on the street is that you got one of those sweet new dirt bikes.
Yeah. Whoa.
Yeah, well, Christopher's always dreaming.
Logan, you're supposed to be up at my father's ranch. What are you always doing at this dump anyway?
I was just about to come up, Abigail, but for the record, I was on my lunch break.
You'd better get up there now. You're supposed to be working my horses. You should be thankful I don't tell Daddy that you're down here.
All right, I'm coming, okay?
What's with the little fan club anyway? Hi, I'm Lindsay. I'm sure you are. Logan, get back up at the ranch. What is wrong with you? Why did you just stand there like an idiot and let her talk to you like that? You know, if you want, I could get her some concrete boots. And
no, it's just the way she is. You get used to it. Well, and considering her dad owns half the county, you kind of have to. And no to those concrete boots. Whatever they are, they don't sound good.
Well, you're absolutely no fun. Come on, let's go. Hello? Oh, you mean my uncle? Yeah, let me see if he's available.
Just take a message.
I'm sorry, he's not available right now. Can I please take a message? Okay. Yeah, I'll tell him that you called. Thanks, you too.
Who's that?
That was Connie. She seemed really nice. She said she's bringing over some chili.
That woman has been nagging at me for years. Always calling up, asking how I am, asking if she can come over. Sometimes she just shows up, knocks at the door. Strange woman, I tell you.
That's the pot calling the kettle black.
What's that?
Oh, nothing. Just a crick in my back. Maybe she likes you.
Huh? Oh, no, no, it's not like that at all. Her husband just died a few years back. She's just running low on people to nag.
Uncle Jack. Maybe she just wants to care for another man. I mean, no offense, but from what I've seen around here, you could use a woman's touch.
Lindsay, you sound just like your mother. Or Connie, too, for that matter. Must happen at a younger age than I thought.
What's that?
That idea of women fixing the guy.
Uncle Jack, shame on you! Women don't think that way, not exactly. They just want to bring joy to those they care for. What I want to know is, why do you keep having all these surgeries? Can't they ever get it right?
Well, it's not every day a man gets shot and survives. I'm just a broken up man. Just like Wildfire. Both seen our better days.
What really happened?
Well, you're old enough, I guess. There's no point in keeping it from you any longer. It happened about 10 years ago. My partner, your father and I, we were both detectives. We weren't regular beat cops, you know. And we heard a dispatch over the radio that a bank was being robbed about four doors down from where we were at a restaurant. And your father, he was gung-ho as always. And he jumped at the chance to save the day. Sometimes I think that badge made him think he was inhuman, like some kind of superhero or something, you know? Anyway, before they finished giving us the information, he was already on his feet and headed towards the bank. I did all I could just to keep up with him. Well, when he got there, it was as if he walked into a twister or something with the bullets flying around. And I remember I saw four gunmen and a lot of distressed hostages. And, well, even after your dad went down, he was still trying to save those people. I'll never forget how hauntingly clear it was when I looked into his eyes. He was asking if everyone was going to be safe. Soon after that, I fell to the floor, and I've been this way ever since.
Well, you both did the right thing, and you both fought for what you believed in. Sometimes that's more important than the net results. That's what makes life worth living. It's what you hold on to. My father was a great man, and I don't want my memory of him to be filled with negative thoughts. It's just not fair. He was a hero, and others live today because of it.
What am I supposed to hold on to? I wake up every day. I could barely get out of bed because it hurts so bad. Well, not just my body, but my conscience, too, for letting you down, letting him down. And I pay for it every day. I can't walk, I can't work, I can't ride Wildfire. Is that what you'd call fair?
Uncle Jack, you're alive. The way I see it, this family already has one inevitable loss. You're choosing to make it two. What about Mom and Nick and the rest of us? Do you really think that's the life that Papa would have wanted for you?
I just don't know anymore, Lindsay. Look, I'm sorry if I'm being too hard on you. You kids don't need any more grief. Who is it?
It's just me. Jack Owens, aren't you going to introduce me?
Oh. Connie, this is my sister's daughter, Lindsay. She's here with her couple of her friends and her little brother, Nick.
Well, knowing that your Uncle Jack isn't much for cooking, I thought that maybe you and your friends might like a home-cooked meal.
Thanks, Connie. I'm sure Nick and my friends Izzy and Madison would love to meet you too, but they're outside somewhere right now.
Oh, I bet that's who I saw target practicing in the barn.
Target practice? That's definitely Madison.
So, Lindsay, what brings you to town?
Well, I think my mom has a plan to reunite us as a family, whether we like it or not. I'm the first wave of the assault.
That's devious. I like it. So tell me, where do I go to join?
Hey, this stuff smells really good.
Jack, leave that alone.
Well, I better go get Izzy, Nick, and Madison before Uncle Jack eats all that chili. It was very nice to meet you, Connie. Thanks again. Nice to meet you.
You too, honey. Now that is one smart girl, Jack. I would bet the apple didn't fall far from the tree.
Well, we both agree on that, that's for sure. Well, maybe my sister's got something bringing us together. I think it's a good thing. At least I hope it is.
Well, Jack, actually we agree on two things. But you're right. Family is family. Just like everything else with life. It's not the bumps or the ups and downs that matter. It's the fact that you held on tight till the finish.
Never give up.
That's right. Never give up on anyone. Including yourself, Jack. Family needs you. So do some other people I know.
Oh, is that right? Mm-hmm. Well, I've got some needs, too.
You boys are all the same.
Well, let's eat.
So Nick, tell me again, how many movies are you and your brother gonna make when you guys get back?
Well, we're not quite sure. I have to talk to my older brother about it. Worries about so many little details. Gotta get back there and help him through it all.
Well, what kind of software are you guys gonna use? Cause I was on the internet and there was a lot to choose from. Like, you can even get special effects software now.
Whoa, Ethan, we haven't really gotten that far yet. Kind of in development. That's an industry term for those of you who don't know. My brother wants to do TV shows, but I'd rather do movies, kind of like George Lucas.
In development, wow. Maybe I could help.
Too bad you don't live in Massachusetts where we live. Sure be tough helping way out here. But I'll tell you what, you could check it out on the web. I'm sure we'll get it up there pretty soon.
Enough of this movie stuff. We all know that the future is in video games, not in films.
Speaking of video games, let's go in and play.
Thanks for listening, Madison. Kind of a lot for one family, right?
Yeah. You know, maybe your mom knew exactly what she was doing when she sent you here to meet with your Uncle Jack first. It's a lot harder for him to climb up with us around. Who knows? Maybe she's healing all of you guys and herself in one swoop.
Madison, you sure are strange, but I could not live without you.
Wait, you're calling me strange?
It's Lindsay, right?
Mm-hmm.
Since Jack's your uncle, you must know how to ride horses pretty well.
Oh, yeah.
Is that right?
Yep, she's the best.
Well, consider yourself signed up for the charity race at my daddy's annual fundraiser.
Okay.
Are you crazy?
We'll be out of town before her daddy's charity whatever.
Oh, and by the way, you'll be racing me.
What was that all about?
Nothing, I just entered Abigail's big charity race.
What? Are you crazy?
That's what I said.
Who's going crazy?
Lindsay. She's gonna race Abigail in her father's fundraiser.
What? In the charity race? Are you crazy?
That's exactly what I said. It's no big deal. I'm just gonna trot around in circles or whatever. I mean, maybe if someone wanted to give me some pointers on horse riding, that'd be great.
Sorry, honey. Count me out.
You have a better chance of talking Abigail into being a kind and caring person.
Whoa, Wildfire.
You know, Lindsay, your uncle's right. You're gonna need a whole lot of luck to win this thing. But I guess if you're willing to work hard, I could help you train. And because plus, if you actually win, it'd be great to be a part of.
Thanks, Logan.
Tries to walk a little closer to catch the scent of her hair. He wants to get to know her, but he does not dare. And every morning he sees her, the girl from his dream. And every night time he needs her, he's coming.
Logan!
Oh, what's up,
Christopher? Hey, it's time to go dirt biking.
Oh, okay, hold on a sec. Hey, I'll see you tomorrow. I'm about to go dirt biking with Christopher.
Have fun, and thanks for all your help. Don't race around too fast.
Dirt biking slowly kind of defeats the point of dirt biking at all.
Kind of like running a horse race at a trot.
Exactly.
All right, let's do it.
Hey, Logan?
Yeah?
Do you think I have a chance to beat Abigail? I mean, do you think the training's worked?
Well, it's definitely been a crash course.
Seriously?
Like I said, it's definitely been a crash course.
Well, thanks for all your support. Go off with your friends. I'll see you tomorrow.
See ya.
Hi, Lucy. Hope you like my hand-me-downs.
What's that supposed to mean? And it's Lindsay.
You should be able to figure it out. You're a city girl. Well, I shouldn't have to tell you. Here's a free clue. Those boots Logan's wearing were a gift from me.
I want you to know you could never lose my heart. Through all space and time, it's not just another line. You'll never have to say goodbye to me. I want you to feel.
Hey, Lindsay. So what time are we going to work on your riding today?
I don't want to talk to you anymore.
Okay, I'll bite. What are you talking about? What do you mean you don't want to talk to me anymore?
Just go away! I already talked with Abigail and... Never mind, it's not even important anymore. Nice boots, by the way.
Whatever. Why do girls have to be so complicated?
Every little star that shines.
What does Lindsay mean, Abigail?
How could you not tell Lindsay about you and Abigail?
See, I have no idea what either of you are talking about.
Lindsay knows that you and Abigail are an item.
That's not true.
What do you mean? Abigail just told Lindsay, and now she's really upset.
I've never had anything with Abigail.
That's not what Abigail told Lindsay.
Abigail's playing her, just like she did with the whole fundraising event. And Lindsay fell for it. Hook, line, and frickin' sinker.
So you're saying that you never dated Abigail?
No, I mean, there's no way. She's an ice queen. Well, not that she's not cute or anything,
Logan,
but...
Logan, watch what you're saying.
Look, she's my boss's daughter.
Oh yeah, that's a great excuse.
Izzy, I'm telling you the truth, I swear. Look, you have to talk to Lindsay and straighten all this out.
I'll give it a shot, but she's really mad right now. Why can't I just talk to her tomorrow?
Well, why would you let her be upset longer than she has to? Could you please just talk to her now?
I guess, but you owe me.
Fine, whatever. Just tell her.
Hey, Lindsay.
What's going on?
Nothing much. Just checking out Wildfire's saddle.
It's really dark in here, isn't it? So I talked to your boy Logan.
Oh. Well, I'm not talking to him, and I don't want to hear anything about him. He wasn't going home, was he?
No, Lindsay. He told me this most fascinating story. This wicked witch was telling somebody these lies to hurt the star-crossed love affair. I wonder if there's anybody in Never Neverland that fits this description.
Izzy, we're in Jordan, not Oz. What do you mean, lies?
Well, according to Logan, they never dated. And he works for her rich daddy, and Logan is the only thing she can't buy. I mean, do you really think that she isn't capable of telling a lie?
Well, there is the fact that she tricked me into entering that horse race, and I'm pretty sure she's not all that happy about us coming into her small town where she rules over all.
Well, what I'm starting to think is two somebodies getting to like each other.
So, what did Logan say?
You know what? All of a sudden, I can't remember. What planet am I on?
Izzy! Get right back to Earth and tell me what he said.
Okay, okay. So Logan really likes you. And I think you really like him. And he just wanted me to make sure you knew the truth.
Well, you are right. I mean, he is pretty cute. And... oh boy, Izzy, I really messed it up this time. Is this fixable?
Maybe you should just be honest with Logan. I think you should go talk to him.
What if he doesn't want to talk to me anymore?
What ifs are for people that don't believe in happy endings?
Time are we training today?
What do you mean, we? You weren't talking to me.
Oh yeah, about that. I may have overreacted a bit.
So Izzy talked to you and told you that Abigail was playing you?
Well, I bet Abigail was giving me some pretty bad information. Look, I'm really sorry.
I just don't know if I can forgive and forget that easy. I mean, you wouldn't believe me, but you'd believe Abigail?
Come on, Logan.
I just don't know. What do you think, Wildfire?
What's that, Wildfire?
Really?
Logan, come on, or else I'm leaving.
She's leaving me, Wildfire. Should I run after her?
Well, I don't know. What do horses do? Really?
Okay, enough is enough. We've got to get training.
You know, she's pretty cute. Especially when she's mad.
Logan, stop talking to the horse and start talking to me.
You notice how she has those little dimples and her eyes keep getting bigger and bigger?
That's it. I am so out of here.
Okay. I'm just kidding. I guess we both had a little fun with each other.
Let me make it up to you at dinner. On me.
Is that because you're the boy, so you're supposed to buy dinner?
All right, you win. You buy dinner. We'll go to Cap'n Jack's.
All right, dinner it is. And you're buying because you invited me.
All right, sounds like a deal and a date. Now, let's get back to teaching you how to beat Abigail. It could have been me by your side. It could have been me day or night. Now I know, now I see. It could have been me in your life. It could have been me every night. Now I know, now I see. It could have been
Just use the signs I showed you. These aren't like the old Wild West days with spurs and a whip. These are true show horses. They understand.
What if he gets out of control? Should I just jump off?
Only if you want to get hurt. Wildfire won't go crazy. He's a trained horse. He may be old, but he'll stay on track.
I don't know, Logan. I'm getting really nervous. The race is just around the corner. I don't know if I can do this.
Abigail's a professional rider. No one will think any less of you if you lose to her.
I just don't know, Logan.
We need some more training.
Not more training. Some vacation this is turning out to be.
Lindsay, you need all the training you can get. You volunteered yourself for this. You need to get more comfortable with Wildfire, and Wildfire needs to get more comfortable with you. That's the only way all these signals will work.
Come on, Wildfire. Okay.
All right.
Ready, Wildfire? Here we go.
Now she won't look back no more. Now she won't look back no more. And she can't look back, so she won't look back no more. Now she won't look back no more. Now she won't look back no more.
This is a really pretty place, Logan. I'm impressed.
Thanks. It's one of my favorites. I just love being down here by the water.
You seem to know a lot about this area. And that mall. A girl could spend a month just browsing.
So what are you saying? That Minnesota's not such a bad place after all?
Whoever said it was?
Well, it seems to me that when you first got to the ranch, you weren't exactly happy to be there.
It wasn't that I wasn't happy to be here. It's just I wasn't all that happy stepping in a pile of... Never mind. But things are definitely starting to look up.
Well, what's that supposed to mean?
I think he can figure it out. Welcome to Captain Jack.
Hi, table for two.
Follow me.
Can I get you anything to drink? Oh, by the way, my name is Brandon. That's with a B for Brandon.
I'd like a pop, please.
I'll have an iced tea.
Oh, wait. No. Let me give you a rundown on the restaurant specials first. Haven't you ever been here before? No, doesn't look like it. Oh, are you from out of town? Oh, that's great. Back to the menu items. I recommend our specialty today, which is baked spaghetti. It's a favorite for most of the people who come to the restaurant, and I would know, because I work 68.2 hours a week, unless I'm out in an audition or I'm at home writing my one-man show. You want to hear about it?
No thanks. But that baked spaghetti sounds great for me.
Oh, yeah, me too. Why not try the local favorite?
Oh, yeah. All right, that's two baked spaghetti. Hey, thanks for picking up on my recommendation. Hey, you there. No, that's not how we do things. We have standards. Who trained you? It couldn't have been me.
Anyway, I got a surprise for you.
What's that?
Well, remember when you went into your guy store?
Yeah.
Well, I decided there needed to be a couple changes around here.
Really? Well, give it up. What is it?
I got you some new riding boots.
So, does this mean I'm yours, or maybe there's a new sheriff in town? When are you planning on heading back to Massachusetts?
Well, first I gotta win that race against Abigail. Do you think I have a chance?
Well, what can I say? I mean, you've only been riding a few days, and Abigail's a professional. You'd need a miracle to beat her.
I'm not sure I believe in miracles. And the only thing bigger than Abigail's horse is her ego. Doesn't look good, huh?
field rider. Even money can't buy that. All you have to do is show up for the race, do your best, and have fun. That's what attracts people to horses in the first place. And that's what most people look for in a race. Just good riders loving the ride.
There's a lot more to life on a horse ranch than I thought. I just didn't realize.
Yeah, I'm sure the mess of a horse ranch doesn't even compare to the glittering lights of the big city.
The city has its messes too, Logan. They're just in different places. And to answer your question, I'll probably be heading back to Massachusetts in about a week or so, after Uncle Jack and my mom catch up.
So, there's no chance you'll be staying in Minnesota?
Wait a minute, what's going on here?
What do you mean?
Not you, Logan. Over there, it's Madison and Christopher.
Hey, Lindsay. Logan, what's up?
What do you mean, what's up? What's going on? Madison?
I don't know what you're talking about. We'll talk about it later. We should go sit down and leave these two lovebirds alone.
Lovebirds?
Hey, you know, Lindsay, you never really answered my question about you staying in Minnesota.
Oh. Well, would you ever consider moving to Massachusetts?
Here we go again.
Well, a girl has to consider her options. I guess I'd move if there was a good reason.
Uh-oh. Sounds like Madison and her day just met Brandon with the beat.
Gotta keep your heels down. That's right. Sit up nice and straight. Good girl. Looking good. Hey, her riding looks a bit better.
Yeah, I'm sure she'll be fine.
Are you two looking at the same person I'm looking at? I've got a betting pool, and I'm so going to rub it in when she loses.
Come on now, is that a nice way to treat your sister?
No, but what do you care? When she loses, she's just gonna come crying to you.
Logan, they just grow up too fast, don't they? Well, I will say this. Us guys, you included, Nick, better be prepared to be supportive if she loses.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to prepare for when she wins.
Yeah, this is Jack.
Hey, Jack. Doc Quigley calling from the office.
Oh, hey, Doc. How you doing?
I'm doing great. Say, I wish I could say the same about Wildfire. Actually, that's why I'm calling. Would it be too much trouble to stop by and see him at the stables today?
Yeah, I can have him in the stable. What time?
How about this afternoon sometime? Yeah, I'm sure it's nothing to worry about. Just some test results that came back, and I'd like to stop by and take a look at them.
All right, see you then.
Whose horse needs to be seen by Doc Quigley?
Oh, it's nothing, I'm sure. He wants to take a look at Wildfire. So when you're done here, why don't you take him up to the barn? He'll be here later this afternoon.
What's wrong with Wildfire?
Well, I guess we'll both have to ask Doc Quigley later today.
Hi, Wildfire. How's it going? How was your day? Really? Wow. You need a breath mint. Jeez. Listen, I really want you to take care of my sister in this race. I mean, if I didn't have her, who would be there to annoy? I could annoy my brother, but he doesn't retaliate like my sister does. And I'd also really miss her because, well, she's been with me all my life. But, yeah, I just really want you to have fun and for everything just to be okay. And no matter what happens, we'll all still love you.
She sits alone and hopes her prince will
come away.
Logan?
Hey, Jack.
Hey.
I fixed up that south corner of the fence and I just ran up some feed. Did Doc stop by yet?
Yeah, he did.
What's wrong? Is something up with Wildfire?
No, everything's fine. You know how doctors are, they always overplay everything.
Is Wildfire okay?
Yeah, he's as healthy as a 15-year-old horse can be, no more, no less. Hey, Logan, let's not let Lindsay know that Doc Quigley was here looking at Wildfire today, all right?
Well, do you think it's the right thing to do?
Yeah, I just need some time to think about it.
Hey, Lindsay, it's Logan. Say, I'm down by the stables right now and, well, you know it's dangerous to ride a horse when it's not healthy. And I probably shouldn't say anything, but earlier today, Uncle Jack and Doc Quigley were taking a look at Wildfire. Not to say anything's wrong, but, well, you know I care about you and I'd hate to see you hurt. And not to mention Wildfire. I think Uncle Jack is concerned too, but he doesn't know how to break it to you. So don't let in that you know. And Lindsay, don't try to overreact about this. Not like a regular girl. I shouldn't have said anything. Look, I'll leave the stable doors open tonight. I'll talk to you later. Bye.
Ethan, send these people away. I need some space.
Get out of here, guys. Go. Leave him alone. Get out of here. Me too?
No, you can stay. I just need some space. You know, it's just gonna get worse when I become more famous.
Yeah, I can understand that, I think. So, Nick, would you say we're like buddies?
Yeah, we're buddies, of course.
Well, like, how good are buddies? Because I'd really like to help you with your movie stuff.
We're like brothers.
Really, that's so cool. Like, we do anything for each other?
Yeah, that's right. We're brothers. Except just don't tell my real brother. He's really jealous of me and, you know, just have it be our little secret.
Yeah, that makes sense. You know, I sure wish I lived in Massachusetts with you. That could help you with your films that are in development.
Well, you're welcome to come anytime. You know what? Enough of this talk. Let's go to the fair. Come on.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You seen Abigail?
No, but Doc quickly might have.
Excuse me, are you Doc Quigley?
Yeah. How can I help you?
Have you seen Abigail?
Abigail, the Arabian, or the...
No, no. She's human, you know, blonde hair, Abigail Hardy.
Oh, yeah. I think her dad owns this place. Yeah, she went down toward the fire pit. That's where I saw her going last time.
Okay, thanks.
Abigail,
there you are.
It's time to go to the fair.
Music and the wheels hum. Liquid courage makes you strong. In a flash of time, it seems so clean. What brought you
again, buddy?
Registration is, well, we are at our record right now.
Awesome. This is going to really help the con. Beautiful weather to boot. Doesn't get any better.
Hi, I need to register for the race tomorrow.
All right. Your name?
Lindsay Owens.
Lindsay.
I'll be riding Wildfire.
Wildfire. Very good.
Excuse me, did you say Lindsay?
Yeah.
Oh, my daughter talks about you all the time.
Oh, who's your daughter?
Oh, Abigail, of course. Oh, she's looking forward to the race with you.
Oh.
And you know what a great mentor she is,
yeah,
of course.
You're
going to have such a good time.
Yeah.
Hi, honey.
I've been looking for you everywhere.
Well, let's get going. Well, good luck on the race tomorrow and helping the cause. Bye-bye.
Won't be much of a race.
Lindsay, don't forget this.
Thank you.
Good luck tomorrow.
Thanks.
Lindsay, what's wrong?
Don't worry about it. It's okay.
All right. Come on.
Tries to walk a little closer to catch the scent of her hair. He wants to get to know her, and he does not dare. And every morning he sees her, the girl from his dream. And every nighttime he needs her, he's coming upon at the sea. He wants to hold her closer, tighter, closer.
Hey, how'd it go?
Good, I'm all signed up.
All right, you know what you're doing?
Well, hey! Okay, so no matter what happens tomorrow, just go out there, relax, don't fall off Wildfire. You'll be fine. We kind of know what you're doing out there. No matter what happens, we'll give you a ride back either way. Oh, thank you, Madison. Even though it is my car.
And just be safe tomorrow, all right? And remember, I'm very proud. Not just because it's Wildfire out there, but because you're with him and your family. It's not something I can do, but it's the next best thing.
Wildfire will take care of you tomorrow, Your Highness.
I know. He told me.
Wildfire talks to you, too?
Wildfire talks to those who listen.
You know, Lindsay, tomorrow, just remember what you were taught. And always follow your instincts. The horses really pick up on that. And plus, I think we can all agree that you've already won this race because your heart's in the right place. And Abigail knows nothing about that.
Nice.
Man, you have really fallen bad, haven't you? But enough about that. Today is about celebration. So let's go get some eats and have some fun ranch style. Besides, it's not Abigail's family, so we might as well enjoy it, all right?
Now that gives me an appetite.
All right, let's go.
Your boy stopped dying, she'll still be waiting for love.
Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and of course, friends. I'd just like to take a moment and thank you for your kind hearts and your tremendous support again with this year's cause. And yes, although we are raising money again, more importantly, we are raising awareness. And I thank you all, and I hope you enjoy this evening. Good night.
Tries to walk a little closer.
Say.
To catch the scent of her
oh,
hair.
Hey, Nick. Oh, hey, Kaylee. Yeah, I was just hanging out with my buddies. Oh, well, I think it's time to dance. I wonder if they know any Jesse McCarthy songs.
Really gotta find Madison. I feel like I've missed so much.
Well, you never know. Maybe Madison's been wondering what's been going on with you and I.
Well, don't just stand there, Logan, because I know you want to dance with me.
Listen, about this whole dancing thing, I'm really not very good.
And about this whole horseback riding thing, I guess we'll just take it slow.
Excuse me, sir. May I please have this next dance?
Spencer, hey! Good to see you.
You too.
What are you doing here?
We just got into town. Me and Mom.
Wow, well, where is she?
You know Mom, she's always hanging around. Have you seen Nick anywhere?
Yeah, he's right over there.
Yeah, I've been looking everywhere for him, thanks.
Oh, man.
And there's a little frustration when he won't follow through. Who his eyes promised something that could make her complete. And she knows only one thing. That right here on the street, she wants to hold him closer.
Jack Owens, you have an important telephone call. Please come to the administration offices.
Jack, what's up?
It's Wildfire. Doesn't look good.
What do you mean? Oh, no. She knows.
Honey, it's not that there's anything wrong. It's just that life has a way of catching up to us all. We Wildfire live life to the fullest. That's all that matters.
I guess it just reminds us how precious life is, how important it is to be a part of it, not just an observer. Something I've been doing for a long time.
Wildfire knew he wasn't going to live much longer.
What makes you say that?
That's what he told me.
It is so beautiful here, Jack. The kids have had a great time.
The kids? You mean the first wave of the assault?
So you got that one, huh?
It's like in high school when you were trying to get me over my first crush. I think it was Jenny. Anyway, Mom came first, and a couple days later you came. Either 1-2 punch.
It was Janet, silly, not Jenny.
Right, right, right.
So it worked back then. How's it working this time?
Well, I won't lie to you, Ava. It still haunts me. David had you and the kids. He had a family. Should have been me that day.
Jack, David loved you as a partner. He loved you as a brother. You know that to be true. He wouldn't want this. He wouldn't want your guilt. He'd want you to be happy, to find love. But Jack, we will be back. All together. As a family. And that family includes you.
Ava, do you miss him?
Logan, Doc Quigley here. Say, when you get to the ranch, connect with Diane. She'll take you to Wildfire's colt, Triton.
To see Uncle Jack's face once he sees Triton. Do you think he'll like the name?
I'm sure he will. Wow, look at him go.
Sure is beautiful.